Everyone has recently been talking about Neon, the serverless Postgres platform, and for good reason. It has some really cool features like branching, being able to scale to zero, and making queries over HTTP, which I think makes it the most cost-effective and performant solution out there. Let me explain why. Just like most other database providers, Neon can support many languages. It's super easy to create a project, connect to it, view, and even query the data in the UI. Neon even has a CLI if you don't want to use the web interface. All of this is pretty standard when it comes to cloud database platforms. So let's go through three things that set Neon apart from the competition. And before we get into it, go ahead and hit subscribe to get more content like this. With a typical cloud database provider, when a connection is made and a query is sent, that goes through the compute layer. And this is what grabs data from the storage, does any necessary calculations, and sends the result back to the client. For many providers, storage and compute are tightly coupled, meaning you pay for both even if the database is idle. Some providers do have compute and storage decoupled, but you still have to pay for some compute even when idle so that they can give you instant availability. For Neon, on the other hand, the compute scales to completely zero. So if the database is idle, you just pay for storage. You can see here for RAM and CPU, there are many times where the database is idle. And you can see here, for example, it took 3 seconds to suspend compute. And around an hour later, it started compute, which took 967 milliseconds. This latency is because my application is in the UK and the database is in Ohio. As well as being great for saving on costs, this decoupled architecture also helps with the next feature. With Neon, you can create branches instantly in the UI or with the CLI for isolating data between different development environments or different PRs if you have a GitHub integration. Branch creation is instant because of something called copy on write. When you make a new branch in Neon, all it does is create a new compute layer, which is a pointer to the same storage as the main branch. This is similar to how branching works in Git. When you change a piece of data on this branch, then Neon just stores that chunk of changed data on this branch instead of duplicating the original database. As well as copy on write, Neon's architecture also lets you time travel for your database. Neon uses object storage a bit like S3, and it uses safekeepers to write all the changes using the write ahead log, and the page server here can fetch and reconstruct the data at a point that the user has requested. So you can travel back to any point in your data, and you can also restore the database back to a previous state. This way of keeping track of changes without duplication reduces storage costs and improves performance. A database connection is typically done via TCP, which makes the connection reliable and persistent. But for serverless platforms like Cloudflare Workers or Vercel Edge functions, TCP is more complex to configure or just isn't even supported. To address this, Neon provides a serverless driver, which allows the client to communicate to the database via HTTP or WebSocket to a proxy, and this proxy communicates to the database via TCP. Let's take a look at how this works. Here is a Cloudflare worker that's been created using the Hono framework. It makes a connection to the database, then makes a query, and returns the results of that query as JSON. This worker has already been deployed. So if we go to the dashboard and visit the worker, we can see it returns the results from the query without having to write any extra code to support a TCP connection. And that's it. Those are just three features that separate Neon from the competition. And if you check out their website, you'll see they have a bunch of other features. I don't know about you, but combined with all these features and their free tier, Neon is now my go-to database platform solution for all of my future projects. Have you tried it? Let me know what you think in the comments.